Greetings, and thank you so much for joining us today here at Full Rhema Ministry. We appreciate you taking the time to view the videos, to listen to the podcast. We thank you so much for your support, for your feedback, your comments, for your emails. We appreciate you connecting with us on all of our social media sites. For those of you on Facebook, you may connect with us on our Soul Rhema Kingdom Authority page. We're on Twitter at Soul Rhema Ministries, and we have a Google page, Believers in Christ Kingdom Authority. Actually, it's a Google community. And we do have the Soul Rhema Ministry page. We are we have a Google group, Kingdom Authority. So we have many ways for you to connect with us. Everybody's not on Twitter. Everybody's not on Facebook, believe it or not. And some people that are on Facebook are not on Google. So you won't always hear the same thing across all of social media because different people. We like to be led of the Holy Spirit, what we share with you. And the podcast thing is new. Of course, the videos we're going to be making available on Facebook, on Google, and on YouTube, our YouTube channel of the same name. You can email us at soulrhemaministries@gmail.com. That's all for as far as connecting with us. Isn't it a beautiful day? It's a beautiful day. This is Tuesday, October 24th. And a few minutes ago, we finished our season of prayer conference call. And, you know, God is just so amazing. And I was sitting here after the call ended, and I just, you know, continued to pray. And as I prayed in the spirit, and I felt led to make another video. I'm not, you know, as comfortable in front of the camera, but you know what? When the Lord tells me to do something, I merely want to be found obedient. It's just, I've learned from the past, it's just too important to just not do what He tells me to do, no matter how I feel about it. I guess that, you know, I had some personal issues, and a few months ago I met a young lady, Gayla Holly, and she came to Ron and Sharon's home, Sharon Knott's home church, and her husband ministered, and she came over and she talked to me afterwards, and I expressed to her why I wasn't as comfortable doing a video, but she told me that I should do some devotionals. And she does like a couple mini devotionals, and I don't know. I said, you know, I told her why, and I said, okay, but, you know, this is what the Lord tells me to do. And I've been feeling led to come out to this park, which is not too far from where I live. And it's a nice little park, as you can see. It's, I'm sitting at one picnic table. There's no grill here, but the other three, you can see one right behind me. I kind of use that as my home background, or, you know, they have a little grill there, so it's a nice little neighborhood park where people can come. There's no playground or anything like that for children, but it's a nice place where you can come and relax and, you know, maybe even spread a blanket out up under a tree or whatever if you like. Oh my goodness, I gotta pause this because here comes the trash truck. Pause the camera. So I'm gonna just keep going. This is one of the issues that we face when we're outside. Now it's blowing pretty good. And the trash truck is coming. Wow. But you know what? God is good. And just because the trash truck coming, it's kind of a reminder to me of life. You can plan for the most wonderful occasion and something can always happen. And it's not that your plans are ruined, but you may have to adjust along the way. And I really didn't know what I was supposed to be sharing with you today, but when it comes to who we are as believers in Christ, we have to be prepared for everything. A lot of times people want things to be perfect. This truck is noisy, and Lord, it sounds like they need to oil something for real. Can we say that in our own lives as believers in Christ? And when I say believers in Christ, those of you who follow this ministry, you know that I mean the people who know their God, who have surrendered their life to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. We're not cookie cutters. We're not people that just go to church and warm the bench. We're people who actually get out and advance the kingdom of God. life happens, and sometimes it's not pleasant. I didn't know what the schedule was, but I saw earlier when we were, and I recorded the secret of prayer, and I was like, oh, well, thank God it's not trash day, because I saw, as I was coming, all the people had their trash cans and stuff out, and they don't put their stuff out unless it's trash day. But yeah, it is. And sometimes a little noise may interfere in the natural sense, but spiritual noise in the spiritual sense interferes with what you're doing, what you're planning, what God is doing in your life. And it can be a distraction. I looked around to see what they were doing, what all the preaching was about when they were down there. They've gone this way and they've gone forward now. And they're moving away. But I was thinking when they came from the other street and turned and went that way, so I knew it's something when he comes back around here, you know. And look at me, I jumped up, but I couldn't pause the camera. I was like, well, you know what, I might as well keep going, because you know what, we cannot pause life when life happens to us. We cannot pause life. Life is going to keep going because you're still breathing, you know. Life is going to keep going. Things are going to still happen. We have to learn to adjust. Sometimes you simply need to adjust, you know, make a course correction. This is something that the Lord has told me before. We have to be open and flexible to making, to Him, making course corrections in our lives. Okay? You understand what I mean? What I'm saying flat out is that we have a plan designed for us by God. He knows all of the zigging and the zagging and the circles and the roundabouts and ways that we're going to go, but He already knows all about that because He's seen it from the beginning to the end. We may sometimes look back at the beginning, and sometimes we don't even see clearly. You know, we have an old saying that says hindsight is always 20/20. Well, that's not correct because it's a matter of perception. That's the key. So, but God knows every time you're going to get off track, every time you're going to try your way and do something different than what He told you to, He knows all about that. And He knows when you're going to get it together and say, you know what, Lord, okay, I'm messing this up, so it's me. And we are the problem. We are always the problem. It's not the enemy. It's not somebody else. Because when we are perfectly obedient to God, we can be like Job. And Job, yes, he suffered, yes, he endured, but God said, that's my boy. He said, that's my boy. And I want you to say, hey, that's my girl. I want to hear that. I want to know that within myself that when God points at me, he said, hey, that's my girl right there. To me, there's nothing more important than the Lord looking at me and smiling on me and say, hey, that's my girl. Why? Because he knows that I trust him that I rest in Him. I'm not dependent on my love for Him. He already showed me that it's minuscule compared to His love for me. So I rest in His love for me. That helps to keep me focused. When I start looking around at things that are going on around me, you need to be aware. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that. I'm not that far from the street. Somebody could come around this nice little curve. It's almost like a U-turn curve. They could come around that curve, and they could lose control. Yeah, there's a tree right there. They could hit that tree, you know. But they may not. I can't. There's nothing wrong with me looking around to see what happened, what's going on. But I say, okay, well, that's all that is. And keep right on, but it doesn't interfere with what I'm doing. That's the place we have to come to. We need to be aware of our surroundings. We need to be aware of what's going on around us. The Word says that we are to be wise as serpents, but as harmless as doves. What does that mean? Well, we need to be prepared in every situation and circumstance that we face and that we encounter wherever we go. And how are we prepared? Because we are in tune with the Spirit. The Holy Spirit will lead us and guide us and tell us if we're going the wrong direction, when we're going to a particular destination, He will tell us the best route to take. Although we may have gone this way 100 times, well, you know, you don't know what's waiting up ahead for you. You don't know what the enemy has planned. You've gotten us. And there are things that absolutely can be avoided. That's the first thing that we need to do is stop thinking that, oh, everything happens to me as God's will. That is a lie from the pit. We get into trouble most of the time because we are not doing what God has told us to do. We bring trouble upon ourselves because we're out of place. How many times, for those of you who have children and grandchildren, and even you yourself heard as you were growing up, if you had done what I told you to do, this would not have happened. I say raise both hands and feet to say I heard that. I heard it not only from me, but I heard it from my sisters. Because, I family of all girls. But I heard that my mother said that to everybody. If you had done what I said, none of this would have happened. So the Lord is telling us the same thing. Do what I tell you. I know what's best for you. It may not seem like it's best for you. It may seem hard to you, but the way of the transgressor is hard. Not the way of the righteous. The way of the righteous person is easier. Why? Because God is with them and they're doing exactly what He wanted to do. So He's there to protect you and keep you and take you through. Take you through your own way, but you get into a mess before you turn to God. So we can't be distracted by life. No matter what comes along, we need to acknowledge it. We can't pretend it's not there, that it's not happening. We do need to acknowledge it, but we cannot allow life's incidents to shift our focus from the kingdom of God to the things of the world. It's that plain and simple. I believe that's all the Lord has for me to tell you today. And that's something that He has told me so many times. And I thank you so much for spending your time with me. I thank you so much for opening your hearts and minds to the will, plan, and purpose of God in your life. And I know that, as the Word says, the work that God began in you, He's faithful. He'll complete. We need to learn how to trust Him. You can't rest in God. Hold a little baby in your arms. And it's an animal. When that animal and that child, when they trust you, you know, they fall right asleep, you know. And babies don't trust some people they just don't like. And they're restless. And children are like that. So we are God's children. We're never going to grow up and do it on our own in this life, in this dispensation. We're not. We're always going to be His children. And He wants us to rest. And so He can cradle us. He wants us to rest in His hands. We don't need to hold on to God. God holds on to us. We just need to stay put. Now, with that being said, I'm going to close now. I thank you so much once again for joining me today. Please remember to contact us and connect with us on social media. You can always just simply email us, soulramaministries@gmail.com. Connect with us on Facebook, on our Soul Rhema's Kingdom Authority page. We're on Twitter, Soul Rhema Ministry. We have a Google community, Believers in Christ Kingdom Authority. And our Google focus group, and Google calls it forums or groups, and it is Kingdom Authority. We appreciate everything, your prayers, your consideration for us, and we are here simply to help the believer in Christ be all that God has called them to release the potential and reach the potential that God has placed within us. It's never too late. No matter how old you are, it's never too late. Because there is someone that God wants you to speak to. There is some life that needs your input.